bad performance from Julianne Moore. That's what I thought. Maps to the Stars. Directed by David Cronenberg, Maps to the Stars stars Mia Wasikowska, Robert Pattinson, Julianne Moore, and John Cusack, and it is a fictional tale behind-the-scenes story of Hollywood actors, and if I say pretty much anything else, it will spoil the film. And I have to say, while this film isn't great, it's certainly not bad. It's a pretty average movie. First of all, the acting is top-notch. Everybody in this movie gives brilliant and nearly perfect performances, especially Julianne Moore, who truly has never given a half-assed performance. She just gives off this vibe that she's never done before. And also, the chemistry between her and Mia Wasikowska is easily the best part of this movie. I mean, Mia Wasikowska is kind of like her assistant, and I thought that worked out really well in the movie. And another thing that I liked is how all the stories intertwined. I thought that was good. Also, the movie does look really, really good. I mean, from its cinematography to its directing, the movie just looks really well shot, and just, it looks like you are in, like, Hollywood, and you just feel it. But besides those things, I do have a few problems with the movie. Although the acting is amazing, the characters themselves that the actors are portraying is terrible. Like, I know you're not supposed to like these people, but Jesus Christ, like, I can love a movie that has terrible characters. I love Wolf of Wall Street. I love The Bling Ring. But this, like, I don't know. It just didn't work for me the way it was, like, all laid out. Another thing that I didn't really like is how badly paced it is. I mean, the first third of the movie, it's actually paced pretty well. The middle of the movie, it loses steam. And then the third act, it picks up steam. And it is very sloppily done. And this movie also has I guess subplot involving, like, ghosts. It's kind of like a ghost movie, and I felt like if we would have extracted that from the plot, then it wouldn't really have made much of a difference, and just overall, I thought it was unnecessary. And if that is not enough, there's a scene done with special effects that might be as bad as Birdemic. Just look for yourself. But in the end, Maps to the Stars is a good movie that I feel like if I watched it again, I would appreciate it more. My final grade is 3 out of 5. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next review.